People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, again, we're continuing the kerosene oil series. But today we're not going to look at your stereotypical kerosene, such as you saw in the ACP Gilbert Kamika case, or in the case involving Charmaine Rattray and her daughter Crystal. Right? Today, we're going to look at what happens when the kerosene takes a more active role in the organization. See, this type of kerosene is not just content with playing the little bit part roles that most kerosene play. You know, make a one phone call here and there, set up a one man here and there, you know, lock a one machine in our tights when police pull it over here and there. No. This kerosene is actually making serious moves, actually moving weight. Now, as you can see on your screen, right there, the man, Andrew Davis, aka Flipper Mafia or Flipper Magla, as he later became known as, the woman in the green dress, that is Marsha Bernard, and the two of them there, man and woman. Now, this case is extraordinary. It's extraordinary because when I first heard how everything was going down, the first thing come to my mind is, me don't know how two people who have children together, can't say them are going to run no kind of enterprise like this. I'm sorry, listen, I know everybody think different, and everybody has their own mind, but there is no way you can tell me, say, me and a woman can live together, we have a family, we have picnic, and me and her in another Diet Coke business. No woman of mine can't in an illegal enterprise with me. You better go sit on one side. So hold on. So when me get catch and you get catch, we'll go look after a picnic then. See, this comes back to what me always say. Come down, we're getting at the video and we're getting to how them get catch and the role of Marsha play. But this just ties into what me say. People look at children as an afterthought. Because if children were at the forefront of people's mind, something like this could never happen. But the mindset is, well, if this happened to me, then my granny can't grow the picnic, then my auntie can't grow the picnic, then this can't. Listen, you and your woman can't in a diet coat business, right? Surely, one hour off a left back, because you're gonna get caged, right? Especially in our uncle someplace, working with a group of Jamaicans, you're going to get caged, right? Now, anyway, let's move into the video. Now, Flipper Mafia, artist, right? Well, a long time a DJ, and of course, some of him sang them. I actually have a song I like, and the one in it will say, him no want a man like him, the girls him don't like him. I like that song, right? But let's be realistic here. Flipper never done make the money for the music compared to what make in the Diet Coke business. Who knows how really Diet Coke Flipper rich offer, right? We know that. Now, this is the thing. Flipper have Wallypa sons. What do you mean by that? In a Yankee terms, when I hear a man say, a man have enough sons, it means them spawn a lot of people who try walking in their footsteps. Enough people, enough youths in the streets now. If you were to really be honest, a Flipper style them I use. Enough youth take Flipper style, enough youth take Radigan style, enough of them old time money, them old time juggies, enough of them man, enough of the youths them they both know. At them money style them really I run with. Right? But Flipper, come to Jamaica, start back in music thing, you know, get a buzz, bring in the Porsche truck, and then bring in the Porsche car. I don't know who remembered when that was going on, but back then it was the hypest thing in the streets. But the next thing we know, the Porsche van crash, then the Porsche car crash, right? The four-door car, the Panamera. And it seemed like a lot of bad luck was surrounding Flipper Mafia. But even when time we hear say Flipper get locked up in America, that never really surprised me. Even though I remember clearly me and my bridging them the reason, and I said, imagine Flipper make all that money a foreign. Flipper come back to Jamaica, live the best life he can live. And you mean tell me say Flipper gonna stay at Jamaica and build something. Flipper couldn't use the money and go to the next level. Flipper still caught up in the same flossing and as big saying a shot as too much flossing, dog. But then, what caught me off guard was when we get to find out the rule that him woman, Marsha, was playing in the organization. I always remember seeing her with this look on her face. Anytime you ever see her, she always had this look like she's there, but she's not really there, like her mind is somewhere else. Even this picture. As you can see, Flipper deep in the kiss, right? Hide them lock in the lover's world. And Fairy hide them and them by her side, like, oh boy, here we go again. Like, I don't know her, let me just put that out there. But in my opinion, I didn't get the impression that Marsha enjoyed the spotlight. I think Flipper loved the limelight. Flipper loved the video light, but it seemed to me like Marsha, her energy was always giving off like, oh man, here we go with the camera them again and the excitement and all of this, right? As I said, I'm just reading body language, I don't know her. But when I read the court documents, some things stood out to me. People, I want you to look at your screen right now. This is an excerpt from the actual court documents, right? And for those of you who can't see, I'm going to read it out to you, but just check out the part that really stand out to me, right? So it's saying that basically, because by this point, Uncle Sam, I follow them, right? Uncle Sam start to track them because, of course, you don't know it already. People in the organization get catch and turn, and they're now helping Uncle Sam gather evidence against Marsha and Flipper and the next youth, Kemar, right, who's his brother. It says, in February 2013, Davis called Kemar to ask about a package that was supposed to arrive at a Vineland address from California. Kemar called the post office, falsely identified himself as Peter Williams, the sender, and was told that the package was en route. Police intercepted the package and discovered several keys of Diet Coke hidden inside CD cases covered in wrapping paper. When Kemar again called the post office, the postal employee, as directed by the police, told him the package could not be delivered due to an insufficient address. See that? By this point, the police, I watched them. Police don't tell the postal workers to listen. Give them a story when they call. Right? But check this out. When time Kemar tell Flipper Wagwan, Flipper tell him say he must get a fake driver's license in the name of Peter Williams so he could ever get the package. You with me? Alright. When them call, right, the postal address, the postal employee tell Kemar say, listen, the package is in the Dead Mail Recovery Center in Atlanta. When Kemar tell Flipper this, Flipper tell him say him no like how that sound. Flipper then tell Kemar he abandoned the package and changed his number. Uncle Sam was trying to pull a fast one on Flipper Magala. And it's like Flipper spot the rake. See, what this tell me now is that Flipper is a man who made foolish decisions, but he's not entirely foolish. So he made dumb moves, but he's not entirely a dummy, right? Because you have people who just, them impulsive and do some things, but this move right here, so Uncle Sam not try to pull upon him. The fact that Flipper tell Kemar, say, listen, leave the package, change your number. That show me, say, Flipper was thinking here, right? Him spot the rake, him smell the rat, right? And him just call it a day. Because that right there was Uncle Sam laying, setting up a slam dunk. If him be ever go down there, right? And boy, man, come collect the package enough, the fake ID name Peter Williams, then who knows where they're going, right? So it shows you say, the signs were there. But if Flipper was truly, truly ahead of his time, if he was really thinking, that right there, so for me, I'd have to go up and explain God Jamaica. If him smell the rat right there, so that is when Flipper should have cut. Because clearly, Uncle Sam, I watch you. And if you spot the rake to the point where you decide to say, you know what, left the package alone, because clearly Uncle Sam was doing something, or you for still end up go get catch down the line upon phone call. Anyway, let's continue, people. But you probably say, boy, Uncle Sam wicked, we're still not here with Marsha do. Where Marsha do? Why them deal with Marsha so? Well, look at your screen. And I quote, also in March 2013, Bernard, which is Marsha, contacted Rivera and asked him to meet in the parking lot of the Red Lobster. Right, so basically them do a deal, right? And then them end up holding upon the youth where she do the deal with, you know, the Red Lobster, where she go exchange a bag with him. And then they holding upon the bag, then find the receipt in Marsha's name from the store where she buy the bag. Later that month, Kemar and Davis, right, that's referring to Kemar and Flipper Mafia, talked about the expected delivery of another package from California to a Princeton address Brown provided. Police watched the delivery. After she received it, Brown called Bernard, who picked it up. Bernard then called McBride to say she would deliver it to him around 7 that night. So you realize what going on. Marsha Bernard was playing a very active role. This wasn't your casual standard do I look at one thing here. No. She was very much in the mix. Premium kerosene. This is not the little cheap kerosene oil. Right? This is the premium one. Right? And you have the little cheap one where them say where them all, you have different grades of kerosene, but these are premium kerosene. So, as you know, and you'd have heard by now because a long time the case come out, Uncle Sam ended up sink Marsha, Flipper, Kemar, right? Couple of them will get locked up, but obviously we are focused on Marsha and Flipper, right? But watch this now, people. Now it reached trial. Them that trial and the evidence that get presented, and most of the evidence was recorded phone conversations, right? Uncle Sam tapped them phone and them thing them. But them attack in a patois. Now enough people think say Uncle Sam a fool. And if them talk in a patois and them talk in a code, Uncle Sam can't decipher it. Well, check this, it's up on your screen. Before trial, the judge stated that he intended to instruct the jury that a court-appointed Jamaican patois interpreter reviewed and in some cases revised the transcript. Uncle Sam go for a yard, man. Uncle Sam was like, oh, only thing someone can talk in a patois and beat the system. Watch this. We go for a Jamaican phone. But that also tell me, say, you see, if Flipper did really heavy like that, me talk submarine money, you know, the kind of money we can get in any system, even Uncle Samon. Him could have even find a way. You see, if him could have get to that Jamaican patois interpreter, Flipper would have probably down the road now. Can you imagine if Flipper did get Simple Simon to be his Jamaican patois interpreter and I listen to what he must say and I translate it for the American justice system? Can you imagine if Simple Simon a work for Flipper? This is what Simon would say.
Yes, Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, when you hear Flipper say he make a mad step, what he means is that he left his house, and as soon as he took one step outside, he suffered a severe mental illness, therefore rendering him incapable of making any kind of rational decision. That is what a mad step means in Jamaican terms. And when you hear Mr. Flipper say that he is a Don and he's going to move some key, you're making a mistake. You think he's talking about the Diet Coke? No. See, what Mr. Flipper is saying is that he wants to go into farming and he's trying to get a donkey because he gets the Don and then he put it to the key. You know, like Shabba say, you put the Don to the key, turn him in a donkey. Listen to that song. My Flipper is actually talking about animals. Your Honor, I think, you know, you have this entirely wrong. These translations, they sound like he's doing Diet Coke business, but trust me, Your Honor, nothing here is of any kind of illegal activities. I think this man is innocent, Your Honor.
Just like that. Anyone Simple Simon did in there? Flipper and Marsha and Kim and the whole of the middle of the road right now. But people, after them get found guilty, guess how the sentencing go? And bear in mind, they were convicted of the same charges, right? Uncle Sam gave them the same charges. That is why I say Marsha was a premium kerosene, right? She was knee-deep in the organization. But watch the sentencing. The first charge, leader of narcotics organization or narcotics trafficking network, them end up say he must get a retrial upon a Monday, right? Now, the next charge then is where him and Marsha get the exact same thing. For those charges, Flipper get 25 years and 12 years of parole ineligibility, right? And Marsha, she got 21 years with 6 years of parole ineligibility. In other words, Flipper get 25 and for 12 of them years, he can't apply for parole, he can't get parole. Marsha get 21 and for 6 years, out of that she can't get parole. Which is strange because they were literally convicted on the exact same charges. Now this is a thing where enough people don't talk about, and it benefits kerosene, and that it is a fact that women get less time for the exact same crimes. Don't take my word for it, it's right there on your screen. You can go do your own Google, your own research, right? See that? Men are given much higher sentences than women convicted of the same crimes in federal court, right? Same charge, but flipper, I've got to do an extra 6 years before him can get no kind of parole, right? So you have to understand, even though the kerosene take part in the organization, right, get synced for the same charge, match the same works, make the same calls, she will do less time. The reality is society just have a softer spot for women than they do men. That's just how life is. That's how it's always been, and in my opinion, that's how it will always be, right? People, when a woman go before the court system, when her eye them start full of water, right, and her cheeks them start to tremble, and the jury and the judge look upon her, and she drop her head and she say, "Your Honor, I'm sorry, Your Honor." And she, especially if she know how to play the game. If she know how to play the game, trust me, that sentence, it's coming down. Judge not really look to fling her, but judge not really fling a woman like that. You can't even look upon murder charge of Jamaica. Check upon the sentences I'm going to tell a woman get sent on a sent, Fort Augustus. Them not get fling with like man. And I see murder charge. But a man, sorry for no, go in front of the court system, especially in America, especially as a Jamaican immigrant, right? In America, I sell Diet Coke. If anything, FIFA Mafia charge, actually, it sounds kind of light, to be honest. But I know it's probably because, you see, the trial, the one that we really want to hold him for, the one that they want to sing him for, is leader of narcotics trafficking network. That one comes with 25 years of parole ineligibility. In other words, you can't get parole for 25 years. And that them they really want to sing clip of her, right? But him end up, them say retrial for that one day. Right, so people, as me say, this is an example now of a premium kerosene. As for what happened to Flipper, well, me say, so while him in a jail, he actually completed his high school diploma. You know, foreign, no for them jail, they're not foreign. Man go in there, and when by the time they come out, then turn professor. Man go in a jail, man drop out of school in the 8th grade, and go to jail are foreign, and by the time he come back, he have all PhD. Right? No for them look at opportunities that are foreign for if a man who in a jail, and enough man take up religion to enough man turn Muslim and anything there. Because they have all the time in the world. When you have nothing but time, then the thing them when you're on the road, you're partying, you want to go, you want to go have fun. But when you have nothing but time, you can take up your book and read, and guess what? The same course them you couldn't find time for the road, you ain't not pass them in the road. We put in the jail, so we say flipper. Have him high school diploma now, and who knows? Next thing we say, flipper have him bachelor's and have him master's, and hey, him not nothing for do, so why not make use of the opportunities? Right, so by the way, people, this is what flipper look like now. As you can see, the man put on a couple pounds, right? And to be honest, I know it's a picture, but he look like he's in good spirits, he look like he's healthy, you know? Face look a little rona, so you know, him not dead for hungry, right? So, what me can say is, he did the crime, same as did the time, but the sentence him get is not like, say, flipper get dashed for eternity, right? We might see Flipper Mafia come back at Jamaica, and who knows? As me say, he might come back Dr. Flipper Mafia. As me say, it's not the end of the world, but, you know, what I've always, are the people whom I always think about first is the pit of them. You know, mother gone, father gone. Of course, I know they can visit, but you have to understand the consequences and things they have from Pitney, right? Are you the same daughter, the will in school and all them things there, but listen, no amount of material things can cancel the fact that there is no mother and father around. It just can't replace that. I'm sure Flipper Mafia Pitney them, nah, they're too hungry and they don't want nothing, right? But you don't know children want and need them parents in them life, right? But as me say, we'll see how this one turn out anyway. People, this is it for today. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA. More life. Bless.